Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Viewers, assalamu alaikum again to those who otherwise are not Muslim by listening to the program. May peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. In my last segment, I mentioned that I'm going to be doing the part two of Was Christ Indeed Crucified? Revisiting new insight using the Quran and the Bible to clarify some of our contention. The Muslim actually believe that the Jew and the Christian, we all came from the same stock. But the baton was given by the Jewish community to the Christian, and they refused to take it. And the Christians were expected to receive the baton from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they rejected it. So you can see clearly there is this kind of dichotomy of religious insurgence that happened. But the Quran is forcefully in telling us that وَلَكَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. To each and every community, the message has been given. Each and every community have seen a messenger or a warner have passed through them. So in essence, it's the same thing. The same religion, geographical differences and ways of applying that religion at the time that the messenger or the prophet brought it to them kind of differ. But the whole, you know, the theme is just the oneness of Allah, the monotheism. And in the Quran, we are told that Jesus Christ did not die on the cross. And the Christians saying he died. You know, because if there is no crucifixion and resurrection, Christianity is going to fall flat on his face. So they have to maintain that ideology of Christ dying on the cross and coming back to life. And so in my last segment, which is the part one, I make mention that Mark chapter 14, verse 50 said, during the most critical time of the life of Christ, all his disciples forsook him and fled. All of them. They all forsook him and fled. They didn't see what happened. So if they didn't see what happened, how could they write something that, you know, about his death? They didn't see. They didn't see. He didn't, you know, none of them saw what happened. And so what happened was that Jesus Christ took his disciples to the Garden of Gethsemane. Because he knew that they were attempting to kill him. So he went to the Garden of Gethsemane, which is very close to, you know, the Temple of Solomon. And he fell down with the disciple and he said to them, sit here and tarry here and wait and watch me. And he went a little further. This is reported in the book of Matthew 26:39. It says, and Jesus went little further and he fell on his face and he prayed and he said, oh, my Father, let this cup pass away from me, not as I will, but as thou will. In other words, let this cup. The word cup, if you have, you know, a concordance with index and reference, another Bible, it tells you that this cup of death is referring to physical death. The cup is referring to the physical death. In other words, Jesus is saying, look, I don't want to die, God Almighty, but if you still want me to die, fine, that's okay. But me, remove this cup of death away from me. He doesn't want to die. The same thing was echoed in the book of Mark, chapter 14, verse 35, where Jesus again pleading to God Almighty not to let him die through the hands of all these wicked people. And he said, Abba, Abba, referring to God Almighty, my Father, Abba, Abba, I know that all things are possible with thee. Please remove this cup away from me. I don't want to taste it. In other words, remove this death away from me. I don't want to taste it. But if you still want me to taste it, fine. Again, Jesus is telling God Almighty that he doesn't want to die. We read that again in the book of Luke chapter 22, verse 35, all the way to verse 40. Jesus saying to the disciple as he came back from, you know, bowing down and praying, are ye even yet without understanding? Are ye even sleeping? Can't you wake up and watch as I pray? You know, they were sleeping and he was doing the prayers. So he was a little bit angry. He said, okay, are you still sleeping? Can't you watch and, you know, watch me whilst I pray, you know, and keep the spirit? And so he went again and fell on his face to the ground and he prayed and worshiped the Lord and asked him not to die. Again, we read in the book of, you know, Hebrews chapter 5, verse 7. It reads, who in the days of his flesh, referring to Jesus, he offered up prayers and crying and supplication to the only one that can save him from death. And he was heard. Heard from what? He was praying to God not to die. And God heard him. Now, if you ask me to give you a Quran and I say, okay, I heard you, I'm going to give it to you. That means I'm going to give it to you. I heard you. But here's a case. Christ is praying to God Almighty not to die. And you are telling me that he died anyway. This is celestial injustice if that happened. Whatever Jesus asked God Almighty, he gave it to him. Because Jesus, he makes us to understand in the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 7, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be, open. What kind of father is that? When you ask him for a bread, he give you a stone. Or you ask him for a fish, he give you a snake. My father give good things to those who ask of him. So ask my father. So if Jesus is asking God Almighty not to die, the Christian is telling me that between God Almighty and Jesus Christ, there was an agreement made that Christ will come and die for the sin of mankind. But clearly, as you can see from, his reaction, he didn't know about this, things that he's supposed to die for mankind. He loved life, so he did not die. Clearly, the Quran said, "Wama kataluhu, wama salabuhu." They did not kill him, nor did they crucify him. It looks like that's what happened. Because those who are involved in this case are full of doubt. They don't know the exact thing that happened. This is the part two. Inshallah, the next part, which is going to be part three, is coming pretty soon. And I'm going to send it out. Definitely, I'm going to leave it at that. Hazza billahi tawfiq. Wassalamu alaikum.